This is the FY2023 Juvenile Justice Delinquency Prevention Grant. Mr. Tyler.
Good morning.
Good morning. So back in April, we were awarded this grant. This is separate from the one, the Juvenile Justice Incentive Grant that we've had for about 9 years now. This is the delinquency prevention for the low-risk youth, what they call the CHINs, the children in need of services, those youth that we're trying to catch before we get before they get into serious trouble and have to go before the judge. So we currently have, the initial grant was for a 6-month period because it came up in the middle of the fiscal year. This will be for a full year, so we're going to run from October 1st to September 30th of next year, and we're eligible to apply for $50,000 in continuation funding, which we hope would allow us to provide two groups. Currently, the first group is about halfway through. Tomorrow night will actually be there midway point, and by all accounts, we need to check in, see what LCC does, and everything seems to be going well and on track. One slight difference in this from the current grant is Evidence-Based Associates has been our program manager. We've contracted with Evidence-Based Associates to manage the grant programs, and they found the providers, selected the providers, and kind of provided oversight. EBA informed us when we got ready to go through putting the renewal application together that they would not be able to support the grant, and for the $50,000, we would not be able to do the two cohorts, the two groups that we had originally planned on. So they decided that they would prefer not to be involved in this grant going forward, which means we would need to select and contract directly with the provider that's running the groups. So unfortunately, removing that layer, we felt like that after talking with the county manager, that one additional step we would need to issue a request for proposal, allow any local providers that are interested in continuing the Strength and Families program going forward, the opportunity to present a proposal. Currently, Peaceway and Mediation and Counseling is doing the grant, and so it may end up that we continue with them, but we did want to make sure that we did things properly and maybe give other providers an opportunity if they so choose. So we will be issuing if we get approval to submit the grant and it's funded, which we have no reason to believe it would not be, we will be issuing an RFP soliciting providers and then come back to you with that selection so that you can contract. So with all that said, if you've got any questions about this particular grant, I'd like to answer.
Any questions for Mr. Tyler?
How many families
is it typically? So we're serving 12 now, so which is one group. So this would allow us to do two groups, which would be a minimum of 24. Now, it would all depend upon, so I would say it would be a minimum of 24, and we got proposals from someone. They said for $50,000 they could run three groups instead of two, and we would do that. But for planning purposes, we're going to plan on that we would only be able to do two groups and more than that. That's great. So this particular SFP is for 7 to 17 year olds.
Actually, I have a quick question. What percent, if any, the participants in this grant are / homeless on that borderline?
To my knowledge, there are no homeless. They all, not to say they couldn't be homeless, but the way this program works is it's for the whole family, so it's a group. I have not been informed that any of the families were homeless. So it's the parents responsible for coming to the class and also bringing the youth. I will verify my MH for you more tonight, but not that it would be excluded, it just, we haven't had any that I'm aware of that were referred, because the referrals come from Department of Juvenile Justice. So, haven't been made aware, but I also haven't asked questions, so that might be what happened.
Appreciate it. It's just inquiring, because it seems like they possibly can benefit as well.
They definitely would be eligible if that were the case. Like I said, I'm just not aware that that's the case with any of these.
Any other questions?
Thank you, Mr. Chairman.